Alright, I'm Matt, and I am once again back with Outer Wilds, hunting for more endings. Turns out I was wrong about a thing or two. One of them being the ability to drop the warp core. And the other being the other being the come on, I'm better remembering stuff usually. Actually, I'm not. The other being the end of the end you get when you do not jump to the eye of the universe after removing the warp core. Also maybe something on Hollow's Lantern. And you get if you don't jump to the eye of the universe is apparently related, or the important thing about that is probably not to not to meditate and possibly not to destroy your ship. Which were both things I did. So the plan I have for that is now to... Oh, what is that? The plan I have now is to how do I land again? There. Is to go to the Adelrock after after getting the warp core. The other thing I should, or that I wanted to check, was in fact finding this. Question is, can I get in here without getting nuked? Be nice if I could. Ah, well, would you look at that. Unbuckle. Seems to work for a given value of working. Timber half projection stone. Okay, what the? Location is now inhospitable. Oh no, it starts up here. Warning, increased solar activity detected. Warning, increased volcanic activity detected. Verdict, location is now inhospitable. Evacuation recommended. Okay. Root. Friends in the Timber Half Mines, the last type of ore you sent us survives the longest in direct heat. Can you send us more of the same for additional testing? We're attempting to improve its durability and our forge has already burned through everything you sent. We'll deliver more ore to Hollow's Lantern immediately. You must be fired up about crafting the Ash Twin Project's protective shell. My gratitude! I imagine we'll also have an updated estimate soon of how much ore is needed to seal off the Ash Twin project. Will it be more than we initially thought? It will be significantly more. The smallest crack or opening in the protective shell would destroy everything. Well, that is interesting. Where is that? That is in the mines. Did I miss a brittle hollow stone there? K. Okay. Yeah, I can't really do anything in here. So, ship log. Volcanic testing site. Interesting. All samples from the Nomai mines on Timberhof were sent to this volcano for durability testing. The Nomai were trying to craft a, briefly, supernova-proof shell to encase the Ash Twin project. Even the smallest crack or opening in the protective shell would destroy everything. Well, maybe we could... Nope. That didn't work. What I didn't check though. I thought I could maybe make my way out, but turns out I could not. Here. Hollow's lantern, okay. That is interesting. Rumor mode there. Might work if I use the correct whatchamacallit. Actually, it's fine. Might work if I use the correct key. So was it here? Yeah, it was. Just gonna land here. Further than I had planned, but okay. Okay, how did this work again? Don't remember how this worked. Oh yeah, like this. Wait, what's that? Oh, that's why. Upstairs. Okay, no, that was that. Down there. No, up here. See? This. So this is Ash Twin. We had that. And indeed, there is no... thingamajig. Whatchamacallit. No brittle hollow. Projection stone. Ah, this would be the way up if I wanted. Gotcha. Thank you. Well, that was not planned, and down we go again. Well, that kind of works. Not quite where I expected to end up, but sure. Let's go with that. Okay. This is here. Oh, no. This is not the way out. Getting all the way up is going to be interesting. But sure. Let's deal with that later. Like this. Oh yeah, that was here. Gotcha. Oh. Never mind then. Ash Twin time. No. Yes. No. Twins took lock on. Oh, yeah. Port hull damaged. That's fine. For now. Okay, port hull. So much for dropping it. Where's the... Okay. Fixed. That. Once again, wrong side of the sun. The other option would be to get on the Quantum Moon, write that out to the whatchamacallit. Nope. That's the Quantum Moon. Where's the damn Etel Rock? And write the Quantum Moon out to the Eye of the Universe. But oh, there it is. That will may become a different attempt. Let's try not to crash. Where's the North Pole? It's the sun. Ok, Okay, that's the big hole. There we go. That's the place I want to be. Boop. Okay. Ah, there we go. Interestingly, I can't drop it. On Ash Twin. But I can drop it on Yaddle Rock. Okay, didn't see anything, so... There's the sun. Might take about 5 minutes, though. I'll bring it back in. When it goes boom. This is taking a lot longer than I anticipated. The sun has increased in size quite a bit. Oh wait, I did read some. There we go. I did read some in the Nomad Mines. That's why. Well, I kind of expected more from that, honestly. But okay. Okay. Maybe it was because I was outside of the ship. So... two more attempts. One inside of the ship and one... the stranger. Well, maybe three more attempts. Although I'm not entirely sure. Close to the equator. I'm not entirely sure if being inside the ship really makes a difference. All right. There we are. Gonna take a nap for 6-7 minutes, I think. There is. Actually, what if? I just boost out. Getting mighty dark out here. Mighty dark. Oops. That wasn't part of the plan. And the sun is going up. That's gonna be exploding a few seconds before I do, I think. Outrun the fireball. I don't think I can. Maybe I can. Well. Well, that was an interesting ending. Definitely an interesting one. So, see, for those off. Gonna doze for 5 minutes or thereabouts, so I can get into the Ash Twin pretty much immediately. Now I reckon 5 minutes might be a little long, but you know. It worked when I was on Ember Twin, so why not? Alright, that should do. Hour 12. Okay, so Stranger. Rumor mode, and I want to go there. Actually, No, actually that doesn't work. Does it? Can't remember. Can't remember if I've been in the simulation. When the sun went up before. I must have been. Haven't I? Can't remember. Why do I always come in so hot? You take you. Got about 10 minutes, so I think I'm gonna take another nap. Let's say 7 minutes. Let's say 5. Interesting that the sparks here are green, which I guess is understandable because the flames are green. Okay, what did I fall on? Oh, that other bridge. Yeah, never mind. There is that other bridge. Forgot about that part. So, shouldn't be more than 5 minutes or thereabouts. Oh. How much time has passed? They don't even bother to hunt you anymore. Time passes and passes until your life before is some half-remembered dream. If only you could wake up. I see, I see, I see. So, I reckon I wouldn't have had to take that nap. After all, at least that second one. The first one we do need. So there we are. Alright, didn't check the time. But we need to find us the quantum moon anyways. Where is it? Oh, that's the Adler Rock. Not a dark bramble. Giant's Deep, there we are. Although it's going to go away, I think. Okay. Can I get a visual on the quantum moon somewhere? It's not there, it is. Theory. There it is. Coming up a little bit hot again. Although 40 meters per second, 50 meters ain't too bad. Well, maybe it is. Anyone you can walk away from, right? So where's north? There's north. Oh, there's water here. Which, unsurprising, because we are dealing with the representation of Giant's Deep. But we should be able to get us... Oh, no, we are not. So... where then? Timber Hearth? Could be, could be. Trees? Trees is good. That's the shuttle, that's the tower. At the North Pole. Good. So, close the door. Nope, that's Timber Hearth. It had to be at the North Pole, didn't it? That's Twins, that's Timber Hearth. Bramble. There we are. Okay. The path to the south. question is, will you comment on me having that warp core? Can I put it here? I can. Explain, identify. Ah, shame. Okay. So, here's a thought. Or thing we found out in the end. This is about the quantum moon and the eye. This is what Solanum has to say on it. I imagine you've noticed the quantum moon changes in appearance depending on which location it is currently orbiting. For instance, the moon looks quite different when orbiting Giant's Deep than it does when orbiting the Hourglass Twins. Because the quantum moon clearly changes in its different forms, the eye, being this moon's primary location, must be similarly malleable. From this we can hypothesize that the eye represents extreme changeability. And that's the truth, ain't it? It's changing the ending universe, or the universe that ended, into a new one. That said, despite its malleable nature, the quantum moon becomes locked to one specific version of itself when it is consciously observed. But what would happen if a conscious observer were to enter the eye? And we did that, didn't we? Entered the eye. Interesting, did I get stuck on that warp core? Mine now. Put it here. Boop. I see. How long have you been here? Minutes? Years? You are unsure, but it seems your journey has reached its end. So, yeah. That's... that's the same thing that Solanum said, wasn't it? Is there anything else I wanted to check? Oh yeah, I wanted to see what happens if I do not enter the eye. Alright. Boom. Actually... that. Darby B. Gravity on deck, but not up top. What is that moving there? That the interloper? Might be. This is the quantum moon. That little speck. That is not the interloper. Is that? Is that the probe? No. Maybe? Can't be the stranger, can it? What is that? Doesn't appear to be anything quantum, but it was definitely weird. That's the quantum moon again. Let's see what happens if my sun explodes. It's entirely possible nothing happens. There it goes. So does it reach here? Or not? I don't think it does. Does not. And so well, it's honestly not surprising because the quantum moon was not affected either. It's dark outside. And yet. Nothing left except the vessel, the eye, and the quantum moon. And me, of course. The vessel? Yeah. Awfully dark out here. So all right then. So that means there is no time limit after you jump out here. Well, except for the oxygen, if you don't make it to the South Pole in time. Last few stars, eh? Why are they blinking like this? Scary dark here. Good thing we have that inbuilt compass. Because otherwise I would have gotten lost just now. It's also interesting that this looked like... Oh, was it this? Oh no, it Never mind. It was a planet, I just didn't see the South Pole. I fell through. Unknown. Okay. Interesting. Let's shed some light on this. Huh. Well, that's interesting. Huh. There we go. Whee! All the stars showing up again. Or, you know, the galaxies. There they go. Oh, I realize what that one thing was that moved, that bright thing near the eye. It was the signal blocker, of course. Yeah, never mind. Of course. Huh. Isn't that just figure? So. Oh, of course, I'm standing on the wrong side. Oh boy. Okay. Okay. This. That was here. Question is, can the fish eat me here? No, it can't. Okay, that's the last two missing. And where are you guys? There. Chip. And there's everybody. Oop. And you don't get to stay out of the firelight. Okay. And there we go, once again. $14.3 billion later, for the third time. Thank you. after apparently leaving the probe or the little scout in the museum room, did not get it into the end screen. Interesting. Interesting. What did I recall it? Don't think I did. Oh well. Or maybe I just didn't pay enough attention just now. In any case, this should actually be the last episode of Outer Wilds, of the Outer Wilds playthrough, because I have no idea what else to do in the game. Unless maybe I do Eye of the Universe speedrun, which is to say starting a new expedition, going straight for the warp core and grabbing hoofing it to the vessel. Although, yeah, should be doable. I mean, I have to go for that for the orange light and dark bramble, and then head on over to the white light that is to the bottom right of the egg clutch. Should be doable. Might have to stop in what's it called? Or on, rather. On Giant's Deep to get the coordinates, although it might be worth a try just using the ones I had just now. Or in this playthrough. I don't know. We'll see. Don't know if I'll do it. We'll see that as well. In any case, with that said, until the next video, thank you and good night.